My name is Danish Yasin. I'm a senior vice president at UniDoc. UniDoc is a collection of professional Golang libraries. And today we're going to discuss UniPDF, which is our core product and it deals with everything PDF. So let's see, what's UniPDF? UniPDF is a Golang-based software library that is there for all of your PDF-related work. It has tons of features. You can create simple documents, work with forms, digitally signed documents, and do a whole lot more. To check out more of our functionalities, you can check out our GitHub repository of examples. We have a rich set of examples there. You can check out how to add annotations, work with barcodes, compress documents, and we follow the GABIC2 standards, so our compression is really good. Apart from that, you can also check out how to create invoices because UniPDF has special methods that deal with invoice generation. So now I'm going to give you a hands-on preview of UniDoc Playground, which is basically a playground that we have created specially for you guys out there so that you can try out the UniDoc code without having to set up anything locally. So here we have the UniDoc Playground. It has the code editor here on the left. You can see the console output here on the bottom left, and there is this preview and file store on the right. You can check out the PDF reports that are created on the file store and open them in the preview. So let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to initialize the creator package variable. We're importing two main packages here, the creator and the model packages. These contain all of the useful methods that you will be needing to, create awesome documents using UniPDF. To learn more about them, you can check out our version 3 release. So here we have defined the creator package variable and we have set the margins of our document that we're about to create. Next up, I'm going to define the buffer variable that stores the everything that we write in the creator package, in the creator variable. So let's go ahead and do that. And then we write everything that we're going to input in the creator variable, and we're going to write it in the buffer. And now this is not needed in the desktop version since we're using it in the playground, we have to write everything into the buffer variable. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, let's use the file store variable to save everything that is in the buffer and create a document out of it. This is something special that you have to do when you're using Playground to use UniPDF. So now that we have defined how to output the file, you can change the name of the file here in the first argument of the file store.save method, and you have to define the buffer that stores all the all the data. So let's move on. Now let's define the fonts that we're about to use in our document. UniPDF has a number of fonts that it has in the library by default. And here we're going to use the Helvetica and its bold version. Now let's create a paragraph. Here's a paragraph. You can define the text in the parentheses. You can set its fonts and the font size and margin and other properties. And then you can draw it up. Literally draw it up on the paper by using the creator's draw method. You just simply write draw and pass the paragraph in the arguments. So let's try this out. Let's try the simple function out. Oops, it's giving us an error on the Helvetica bold. It's not being used. Golang. So let's comment it out and then we'll try again. Here you go. Now you have a simple PDF report that we just created. It just contains a single heading, UniDoc. So there you have it. Now let's do some more work. Let's create another paragraph. Now here we have another paragraph. It has the text example text and it's using Helvetica bold. So let's uncomment that. And now let's draw it as well. Now let's check the output. Let's run this. Takes a few seconds to process it all. And there we have it, a new report. Now it contains the UniDoc text and the example page that we have just created. So now that we have the headings, let's define a paragraph of text. So for that, let's define a text variable. because, you know, we don't want to define the whole long text in the parentheses of a paragraph. So let's use this in the paragraph. Let's create a new paragraph that uses this text variable. So let's go ahead and do that. Here we have a new paragraph that accepts the text variable in its arguments, and then it defines all the properties of the paragraph. We've also defined the text alignment here using the creator.text alignment methods. So let's draw this up as well. And let's run it. Let's wait a few seconds for it to run. And now we'll have a beautiful document with the headings and the example text. You know, here we have it. So with all this, you have learned how to create a simple PDF report by using UniPDF. You can add a title to it and then save it. After saving it, you can easily access your playground example by using this URL. So you have to keep it safe to, you know, get access back to it. After saving it, you can also embed it in your website by using the embed button to get the script that will be needed to embed the playground on your website. And this is it. This is how you can create a simple PDF report by using UniPDF. It has a lot of other functionalities that you can, you know, use in your daily office work. And if you guys have any other examples that you would like us to cover, feel free to go at us and contact us through the contact us button on our website, or you can, you know, create an issue on the GitHub repository. We'll get back to you and we'll start adding functionalities. We're all constantly improving our libraries. So good luck, guys, and happy gophering.